Understanding how to manage your orders is essential to running your business. This video will cover setting up order notifications, viewing and processing your orders, and tools you can use to streamline your order fulfillment process. BigCommerce stores are already set up by default to send email alerts when an order is placed or when a customer has created an order message. The order notifications are sent to the email address you provided during store creation. If you need to change this email address, go to Advanced Settings, then Order Notifications. The email message option is checked by default when the store is created. Click the Email Message tab and use this field to update the email that you want to use to receive order notifications. You can enter multiple email addresses as long as they are separated by a comma. Click Save when you are finished. Now that you've set an email address, let's go to the View Orders screen by clicking on Orders. This is where you'll manage orders. The first thing to notice are the tabs across the top. All orders will be selected by default, but there are a few alternative views to see specific order criteria. For example, if you only wanted to see orders that have been paid for but not shipped, switch the view to Awaiting Fulfillment. Additionally, you can create your own filter through Custom Views. To search for specific orders, use the Filter by Keyword field, or start an advanced search by clicking here. Now let's look at an order in more detail. These icons represent where the order was placed. If you hover over them, you will see labels like Storefront, eBay, Facebook, Mobile Device, or even Manual Order, which means you created the order within your control panel. The flags indicate the country the order was placed in based on the shopper's IP address. If you see this warning icon, it means the order is flagged as suspicious and possibly fraudulent, since the billing address doesn't match the country of origin based on IP address. View the details of an order by clicking the plus icon to the left of the order. You can view the details of all orders by clicking the plus icon located on the menu bar. The first column displays the order's billing information. The second displays its shipping information. And finally, this column features cart contents like quantities, options, charges, and other details pertaining to the items included in the order. If you have any custom form fields in your checkout, you will see them here. And if your payment gateway is set up as authorized only, you can capture the payment here. To the far right, you'll find the Actions menu that allows you to process orders. Clicking here will reveal what actions can be performed for an order, such as editing the details of the order, printing an invoice or packing slip, shipping the products, and refunding a payment, just to name a few. To learn more about these actions, see the support portal. It's worth noting that these actions will change the status of the order, but manually changing the order status will not perform an action. For example, if you want to refund a customer's order, you will need to use the Refund action in this menu. Only changing the order status in the drop-down menu will not refund the order. In addition to the Action menu, you can use the Choose an Action drop-down menu at the top of the order table. It allows you to apply certain actions in bulk to multiple orders like capture funds for selected orders, export orders, archive selected orders, or updating the order status. To apply an order status or perform an action in bulk, check the box to the left of each desired order, then select an action from this drop-down and click Confirm. As volume increases, archiving becomes a useful tool for keeping your order area tidy. You can view archived orders by going to More in the tabs along the top. When the status of an order changes, an email notification will be sent to your customer. If you want to adjust this communication frequency, go to Advanced Settings, then Checkout. Scroll down to Order Settings and select which statuses will send a customer notification email when changed. Click Save when you are finished. When you're ready to ship an item, you can use the Ship Items action to create a shipment for an order. This window will allow you to adjust the shipment details. Next, choose which carrier you're using from this drop-down menu. If you're based in the United States, you will see a list of USPS package and service combinations that your shipment qualifies for. If you're shipping with a different service, you can enter the tracking ID here. Keep this box checked if you would like to update the order status and send a notification email to your customer that their order has shipped. When you're finished, click Create Shipment. If you are using USPS by Endicia, you can print shipping labels directly from the shipment page. If not, our integration with ShipStation will let you print shipping labels for USPS, FedEx, UPS, DHL, Australia Post, Canada Post, and many more. ShipStation will also let you print labels in batches. In addition, we integrate with several order fulfillment apps that can print shipping labels, automate fulfillment, work with dropshippers and fulfillment centers, and more. Be sure to check out the order management section of the App Store. BigCommerce provides many options for you to choose from to find the right method for order fulfillment to suit your business needs. For additional guides and articles about order management, check out the support portal.